Peter, a win and a clean sheet to start the season, you must be happy with that.
Yeah, it was the second half. I thought the first half were very poor. I thought we gave the ball away too often. Brighton were much better and much brighter than us with the ball and against the ball. And I thought as a team we were, as I say, we were disjointed. We passed the ball very poorly. And as a team, and our work ethic within the team was very poor. So the blessing of the first half was the fact to be having no goals against. Marek had a great save, a one-on-one, so I was delighted for him. But the general, as I say, the first half was very poor. Second half was much, much more like what we were expecting from them. They played with a purpose, they played with a passion, we created chances, missed too many. But I think it was about 20, 25 minutes before breaking in our half, I think, never mind our box, the second half. And I think that was just down to the attitude, never mind about the talent, because if you don't have the attitude to match with that, it's not worth anything. I think the second half they showed that, and I think we'd run out right for winners in the second half performance.
And Stephen Humphreys got a goal after he'd had a day where he'd had plenty of chances. How's he made the step up to under-21 football? I know he had a couple of appearances at the end of last season. How's he coped with the step up?
The disappointing thing about Stephen in the first half, I thought he was lazy in his performance. I thought his first touch was poor. You know, his link-up play was poor. So his all-round game in the first half had to improve 100%. And we told him in no uncertain terms that at half-time, because we've said to the boys before, age doesn't matter when you come in now. We can make excuses being a young team last year, a young team this year. So we're at a stage now where men, you have to play with a purpose in your game. And in the second half he showed it wasn't just his goal and the chances they got, and he should have scored more, but it was his work ethic and making it difficult for defenders. And the more he does that, because he's a big lad, but he has to use that frame. He gets into good positions in the box and, as I say, missed too many chances. But he only got that because of his work ethic. If you look at the work ethic he had in Redford, that's what Stephen has to achieve as well. The only thing we are in is he's erratic in front of goals and missed too many chances as well. So we have to get much better at that. As you said, the first thing was we get a clean sheet, which is unusual for us. I thought we looked a lot better defensively. But we have to score more of our chances. But I was more pleased, as I say, with the work ethic and the desire to do the things that were asked of in the second half. And as I say, I think on the second half performance, they deserve to win the game.
You touched on the defensive performance there. I remember you saying a couple of times last season, silly errors you had to cut out. Is that something you've been working on in pre-season?
Yes, it has. It's been a bit of a stop-start pre-season for us in many ways, because some of the boys have been up with the first team, then the 18s were away last week in Switzerland. So it's been a bit up and down with us not being able to work with a group of players. So we're a little bit disappointed at that, because it gives you a chance to work on, as you say, aspects of the game. And we spoke about that last year, where teams have a team. We don't have that yet. And you can see that with young Ian playing for us, the balance in the midfield, that all takes part of your defending. Your strikers are part of your defending, and as I say, the first half we didn't do that. I thought second half, as I say, I think they had one shot at goal the second half, and I think that was great credit to the team in general. The strikers putting pressure on up front, the midfield balance was better, and we were going forward. I thought the defenders were better organising. I think that's why it made it better for us compared to last season, where we were very open with two full backs going, leaving two defenders at back against two, and I think today we've done that much, much better.
And you touched on it a couple of times, it's going to be a very young team this season, but do you expect to have a couple more senior under-21 players available? Is it just a case today, obviously with the trip to Cardiff tomorrow, that they've all travelled?
Yes, well, that's one of the reasons we have the game on the Friday, because if Kit doesn't take some of the boys that can play for the 21s, because you're only allowed three overagers, but we have a lot of young ones even in the first team squad. But if they were available and weren't travelling, it gives them a game, because with the first team having a game on Tuesday again, at least they've got game time in their legs. And we felt there was too many of the youngsters last year missed a lot of game time, and we've got to make sure that doesn't happen again this time. We have to be ready, so if they're called upon in the first team or Kit needs them for the first team games, they are available, but they've also got games in their legs. So today's worked out fantastically well. All the other boys that's not involved I'll be involved with the first team tomorrow, but any time that they're not available and they're not travelling with the first team, I'm not going to be involved in the Saturday with the first team. It gives them an opportunity to play matches, and I think that's the most important thing at this stage in their careers.
And finally, young Tyre went off with an injury. What are the early signs on him?
Well, he landed on his shoulder and it was very tender on the bone. We're hoping he's got away with it, you know, and hopefully it's not broken or anything like that, because I thought he was doing well in the first half for us, and he was giving us a little bit. He had a fantastic pass early in the game, and it was just a shame that he went off, because he's just back from an injury that he got in Guimaraes. So we're disappointed for him, because he's got a bright future and he shows the correct attitude. So hopefully it's just a knock more than anything else, and he'll be available for next week.